Ladies and gentlemen, making that ukulele sing, Punahou's very own Ryan Nakagawa.
And outside hitter, 6'6", sophomore from Virginia Beach, Virginia, number 3, Brad Rosenmeyer. And middle blocker, 6'6", senior from San, Norway, co-captain, number 8, Hendrik Mol. And opposite, 6'7", senior from Macclesfield, England, co-captain, number 9, Iain McKellar. And Lee Barrow, 6'2", sophomore from Honolulu, number 14, Larry Tui Turinata. And middle blocker, 6'10", freshman from Clovis, California, number 15, Patrick. And outside hitter, 6'5", senior from Honolulu, number 21, Kupono. And at center, 6'5", senior from Westlake Village, California, floor captain, number 10, Jennings, Franciskovic. The Hawaii staff graduate assistant, Gabby Mataotia. Assistant coach, Josh Walker. Associate coach, Milan Zarkovic. Head coach for your Rainbow Warriors, Charlie Wade.
And with that, we are playing volleyball here at the Stan Sheriff Center on senior night. Jennings Franciskovic going outside to Rosenmeyer. He gets the scoring started. FCU starting lineup strolling in the bottom right corner of your screen. CSUN coming in 12-13 overall, now 5-11 in the MPSF after last night's sweep defeat at the hands of Hawaii. Rainbow Warriors now 21-4 overall, 11-4, and still in third place in the league. Middle set goes to Eric Chance, and he gets the point for CSUN. He was doing a whole lot of that efficiently last night.
He took a lot of chances last night, and it was errorless. 8 kills, no errors. Hit 800 on the night.
Throw in a couple of blocks for good measure.
Nice to see Iain McKellar getting the start tonight. Got two good serves in right away.
Dimitar Kalchev with the serve there. How about another senior in the lineup, Jennings Franciskovic, the fixture at center this year with the dump shot. That was a no-looker.
That was a great no-look shot. The Hawaii passer is certainly relieved to see that Kalchev has passed his serving rotation.
So all four seniors in the starting lineup here tonight. Middle set, that's Chance again. That is like clockwork right now for the Matadors.
He's now got 10 kills over the two nights and no errors. Still playing errorless volleyball at the net.
Hitting 466 for the season coming into this match. Now the float serve handled by Tui Tuileta. Middle set, Hendrik Mol. Good diving save there. Sent back over. Outside, it's Kupono Faye. Senior to senior connection. Jennings to Kupono.
Kupono Faye off to a hot start right now. Two great line shots. Jennings Franciskovic putting perfect location on that one, giving Kupono a chance to go down that line.
Had 10 kills last night. Now 6 double-figure kill totals in his last 9 matches. He has really turned it on here in recent weeks. This is Arvis Green trying to go over the top. Good save there by Hendrik Mol. Faye the dink. And that one saved by Sam Porter, the setter, but CSUN couldn't track it down on the second touch. That was Suarez trying to chase it. CJ Suarez, the 5'10 senior libero for the Matadors, and it's a quick 4-2 advantage for
him. He had a great night last night, didn't he? 9 digs. And he dug up some just an amazing shot from Hawaii's attackers.
Yeah, some of the hardest hit missiles that he was able to pop up.
Mole ramps up that serve a little bit. Got up to 65 miles an hour.
A questionable set by Porter. Got some moans and groans from the crowd. It winds up a net violation against Hawaii. And Arvis Green now back to serve. Entered the week 5th in the NCAA with 4.11 kills per set. He is an incredible leaper off of the Terraflex. Jump serve handled by Rosenmeier. Outside it's Faye. Diving save there by Suarez. The set a little off the mark, so chance here for Hawaii. Jennings, second touch, they were ready for him, and he still plucked it through.
I don't know how he got that through. Two blockers up, it was like, okay, Jennings, we're gonna make sure you get away with no more dump shots, and he does anyway.
One of those blockers was Josiah Byers. He's the leader in that department for CSUN, but yeah, that's already a second kill here for Franciskovic, 5 serving 3. Outside, this is Skyler Lillithorpe. Now Faye gets another crack at it. Suarez, perfect dig once again. Green from the back row. And it's going to be a Hawaii point. Back row attacker called against Green. He stepped on that 3-meter line.
Exactly. Well, I got lucky there. He was so efficient from the back row last night. When he gets to the front row, he just plain goes OTT over the top of whatever block Hawaii puts up. Even if one of those blockers is 6'10".
One of those things you can't really game plan for all that much, at least when it comes to blocking schematics. Speaking of blocking schematics, how about the fist pump from Sir Iain McKellar?
Sir Iain McKellar's already got a dig, and he's got a block. And that block was straight down, no way to cover that one.
Right next to Pat Gasman.
What a journey he's had. What a journey McKellar's had.
Making his first start of the season. And it's an ace by Jennings Franciskovic. And a timeout by CSUN. Sensing the enthusiasm swelling on senior night. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match. C-Mac, what do you think?
Well, for CSUN, they just got to go for broke. You know, this very slim chance they're going to make the playoffs, so it's best for them to send their seniors out at the Stan Sheriff Center. Just by playing loose and going for broke. Hawaii, one point at a time. They just cannot look ahead to the UCLA matches that loom down the road. If they do that, they're going to get caught by a very good CSUN team.
Already forcing a timeout by the Matadors. 8 serving 3 out of the break. And that's Josiah Byers, who struggled last night. Just 2 kills on 9 attempts. He flatlined it. And he is a guy that head coach Jeff Campbell said, we need, in order to have success tonight, him to have a better match. And he fully expected him to have a better match.
He did. He predicted it. You watched Byers. He said, Byers is going to play better tonight.
Here's Kupono Faye trying to slice that one. Missed it wide. Out of the timeout, 2 consecutive points for the Matadors.
Kupono was expecting what's called a red, a fast set to that right side antenna. Instead, it was more of a lobby set. Kupono got in underneath it and couldn't quite bring it back into play.
Skyler Lillithorpe with the serve forces the overpass. And it is thrown down by Josiah Byer. So already starting to make more of an impact here in the early going of this one, and it's a 3-0 CSUN run.
Hey, no out, no outside.
This is a very good CSUN team that Hawaii's got to be aware of. Last night, as we said earlier, 2 deuce games last night.
Yeah. Could have definitely gone more than 3 sets. Here's McKellar getting a swing on the outside, and he sends that one far away. And it's now 4 straight points ripped off by the Matadors to jump right back in the mix. Hawaii had him up 8-3 until the timeout by Jeff Campbell.
That was a tough swing for Iain McKellar there. Ball being set high, deep from the back row, and he's a lefty coming across his body. A little bit tougher swing.
Jennings, here's McKellar against a triple block. And Iain McKellar gets a kill to go along with his earlier roof.
There's the parents section for the parents who flew in for this match, the Franciskoviches and the Mol, Rita Mol's there, and of course Shelly Faye and Kyle. It's a great group there sitting all together, huh?
Yeah, you saw the McKellar clan in the middle of all that. Dad John, Mom Carol, and his brother Chris all heading out to Hawaii for senior night, and that was an absolute bomb perpetrated by Dimitar Kalchev. First time we have called his name offensively here tonight.
Arm he's got. Ace leader in the country. He hits the fastest serve in the country, probably over 70 miles an hour. And it's a pretty good line shot, too.
And we'll do a little bit of talking through the net as well, as we saw down the stretch of the match last night, as CSUN was on the verge of winning that third game, actually had a set point, but then Hawaii was able to put it together and score a couple of consecutive ones, and they actually involved two hitting errors by Kalchev.
One cross court, one down the line.
Yeah, one that was roofed by Stein von Tilburg on match point. Here's Rosenmeier. High hands there. Chance here for the Matadors. Here's Green. And he was able to rub that through the block. But it's going to be another back row attack violation by Green. Second one of the set. That gives Hawaii a three-point advantage.
That means either Green's not paying attention to his footwork or the set is too close to the net. He's having to chase it down. Maybe a little bit of each.
And Hendrik Mol having to make an adjustment with his lenses. Taking a shot to the grill. Hendrik Mol, one of the seniors tonight, 6'6", from Sand, Norway, has been through so much. I mean, you talk about the
people
journey.
People might not all know why he's wearing those glasses.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about the journey of Iain McKellar and some of the other seniors, but Hendrik Mol limited to just 12 matches a couple of seasons ago due to an eye infection, so he only has about 5 to 10% vision in his left eye, as that was CSUN not able to transition offensively. And Hawaii up four.
He went to UCLA Medical Center for about, I think, 6 weeks and just sort of checked out and had to really pay attention to that infection that he had.
Mom Marita in the house tonight.
96 Olympian for Norway.
Yeah, on the beach. It's a pound off the block by Kalchev.
McKellar did a nice job of getting his hands on that. Usually when Kalchev goes up one-on-one, he finds a way to go around that block, but Iain did a nice job of getting his hands on that one.
So 9 serving 12, and it's Sam Porter, the 6'3 sophomore from Chesapeake, Virginia, with the serve. Middle set, Hendrik. Holy moly.
Senior to senior. Nice connection. Hendrik Mol so used to getting those sets from Jennings Franciskovic. 4 years they've been connecting.
And now Iain McKellar once again back to serve. Was a goalkeeper in soccer when he was younger. In fact, had a short stint with the Manchester City junior team. Oh, good up there by Tui. The set by Faye to Rosenmeier. Chance here for the Matadors. Bump set, Green. A little joust at the net. Mol will have a chance on it, and he'll pump it down.
Wow, what a bizarre play at the net. Boy, his blockers didn't know where the ball was. Luckily, one of them tapped it over the net, and then it came back in an overpass. There's the block there. Mol just sort of slaps that. Then there's an overpass, and Mol gets to put down legitimately. Well, it was a bizarre play.
Yeah, maybe the only error Eric Chance has made here in the islands. And that one is an out ball by Dimitar Kalchev. Looks up at the top official, Bill Forrester, asks for a touch, didn't get it. Hawaii first to 15. They lead by a half dozen, set one.
Rainbow Warrior Volleyball on OCSports is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, Kaiser Permanente, and Island Air.
Welcome back. Hawaii up 15-9 here in the first, and here is Iain McKellar making his first start of the season, one of the four seniors who will be honored at the end of the match. Almost got an ace down. Kalchev, Hawaii's block getting a touch. Outside it goes to Rosie. And it's all smelling like roses right now for Hawaii. As they've scored four straight, they lead by seven, but there is a plea from some of the CSUN players to head coach Jeff Campbell to challenge something on that play.
Let's see if he's going for the, if he's going for the paddle.
He's taking his time if he is, and doesn't look like he is going to reach for it. 16 serving 9. Here it comes from Iain McKellar again. Green vaults up off the turf. What a dig by Fay. He has to send it over, and he does. Green again. The touch shot. Diving effort by McKellar comes up empty. But Kupono Fay with one of his great saves in his elite career.
And the fans appreciate it, giving him almost a standing ovation. There you see him popping it up, keeping that rally alive, and then hitting the ball back from the 28-foot line. Not bad.
That's about as good as it gets. I mean, full horizontal.
Hey, you ready for out of system? Take your out of system here.
Kupono, the 6'5 senior out of Punahou, has a lineage here with the University of Hawaii. Mom Shelley played hoops here at UH. Grandfather Harry Clown Kahuanui, football legend, was an All-American here at the University of Hawaii.
I didn't see how hard he hit that, but I'm sure it wasn't one of his 70-mile-an-hour heaters. It looked more like it was about 55. Unusual miss by Kalchev, one of the best servers in the country.
Oh, yeah, he leads the nation in aces per set, but wasn't quite himself last night. He did get a couple of aces as Green just detonates
on that set. Green just hit the left leg of Franciskovic, and Franciskovic was on about the 6-foot line. This is crazy. Green goes up so high, and here's Francis, but he thinks he's going to get the tip. Instead, he just gets hammered there on the leg.
Here's Mol in the middle, didn't get all of it. Kind of paintbrushed it a little bit, but Hawaii gets the point anyway. So Hendrik Mol now with 3 kills on 5 attempts. That's tops for the team. Britt Rosenmeier with 2 kills on 4 swings. Jennings Franciskovic, the setter, he's got a pair of kills on 2 dump shots. None of those 3 players with errors yet. Here's Mol, the royal serve. Backside, it's Green, way up in the atmosphere.
Once again, not a fair fight. When he gets up there and he's touching 12-1, he's going up against Kupono Fay, who's 6'4", and has pretty good hops himself, but still, reaching for the clouds and trying to block Arvis Green. He's unbelievable.
12 serving 18. Middle set, Gassman, that was a little low. The diving save by Suarez. Here's Green from the back row. Rejected! The Rainbow Roofers in the house.
And that time the Rainbow block was very organized. They knew it was going back to Green, so they had 6 hands across. Gassman, I think, got most of it there at 6'10 in the middle.
Hawaii out blocking CSUN last night, 9.5-5. Middle set, and that's Byers sends it wide. Was there a touch? No touch. And Hawaii has opened up an 8-point lead here in the first set. That prompts another timeout from Matador's head coach, Jeff Campbell.
Rainbow Warrior Volleyball on OC Sports is sponsored by Strong and Hawaii Honda Dealers.
Welcome back. Let's take a look at tonight's Jack Fact. Successful senior class with 76 career victories. The 2017 senior group of Kupono Fay, Jennings Franciskovic, Iain McKellar, and Hendrik Mol have accumulated the 4th most wins of any group of seniors in UH men's volleyball history. The record is 86 for the group that came in the mid to late 90s. And of course, potentially, there's about 8 or 9 more matches for this team to play this year.
Exactly. It's what a record they've set. Well, after a timeout, that was a great serve.
Jennings sets up Gassman. He's a little bit tight in that area, and Gassman wasn't able to get full extension.
Not sure the best choice there. It was pretty obvious the pass was so good that the other team's expecting the ball to be set to the middle anyway. Maybe a set to Kupono or Iain McKellar or a Bick out to the back row might have been nice.
Here's Lilythorpe coming with it. 13 serving 20. Franciskovic backside. It's Fay into the pin. And CSUN letting out a growl as they have scored a couple of consecutive points.
Both of them on Hawaii's unforced errors. so I don't think they can growl too much.
The pass there by Rosie. Jennings high and away. It's McKellar. And he sends it long. No touch there. And that is three straight hitting errors by Hawaii. As you said, sort of the unforced variety. And CSUN within a handful. They don't die easy, this Matador squad.
No, they're scrappy, well-coached, highly skilled, physical team.
McKellar sends it long again.
Timeout. I'm sure Charlie's got to, he's got to call a timeout here.
So that's four straight points for CSUN. Let's send it over to Ryan Kalesuji. He's got some special guests in his midst.
Hey, thanks, Kunal. We are here in the stands with some of the moms who've made it all the way across the world, really. We have the McKellars here. We also have Hendrik Mol's mother, as well as Jennings' mother. We're going to start off with Ian's mother. Carol, what was it like with CSUN introduced here and being here on senior night?
It's been amazing. It's been such a great experience the whole time. And to see him playing tonight on his senior night, it's just a dream come true, really.
I'm going to do Marita. Hendrik has gone through a lot, obviously, with his career, with his eye, and you've kind of been through that process. What is it like to kind of see him now in this his senior season? Obviously, some limitations with his eye, but healed and playing at the top level.
Well, I'm just so happy that he has come back so strong. It was a hard time for him, for us as a family, but we're just so grateful and so happy that he's back playing at this level. So happy.
And finally, Jennings' mom. What has this ride been like for you, being able to watch your son play here in this environment and really connecting with these other moms as well?
This has just been a blessing. We go back from the 4 years here and we are just all reveling in how wonderful and glorious this is. There's no place to play like in Hawaii, and we're blessed to be here.
Well, thank you so much for taking time. Best of wishes to you guys. We'll send it back over to you, Kanoa.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. Good to hear from
good
the family
stuff.
Members.
Very, good stuff. That's awesome.
Very proud of what their sons have done here at the University of Hawaii. Nobody does senior night quite like they do here in the islands. And of course, that ceremony will come at the conclusion of this match, but CSUN making this first set a tad bit more interesting after a 4-0 run. Out of the timeout, Tuileta with the pass. Backside, it's Faye, and he terminates.
Finally stops the bleeding after four unforced hitting errors. Twice before that, hitting 125. You know, they normally hit, you know, 320 and so.
Yeah.
A couple hundred points below their average. Luckily, they're holding CSUN to 107. A couple hundred points behind their, below their average.
Kupono is hitting negative numbers. He's now flatlining it after that kill. Josiah Byers goes off the block and down. So already, Byers out-totaling what he did in terms of kills last night. And two kills last night. He's got three here in this opening set. Jennings outside. It's Rosenmeier. Solo roof by Sam Porter. Now here is the question. If you're Charlie Wade, you have started Iain McKellar. It's senior night, but you start him at opposite, and of course you have your potential first team All-American Stein von Tilburg waiting in the wings. How long do you keep him waiting?
You know, that's a great question. I don't think Charlie's going to wait too much longer. He's not going to risk the game, I don't think. He had too big a lead. Maybe coming sooner rather than later. Let's see. He doesn't seem to be moving toward the bench. He didn't tell him Stein to warm up. Oh, he just now turned toward the bench. And there may be a substitution coming up because clearly Wade does not want to let this first set get away.
It was an 8-point lead. It's down to two. Jennings. Pipe set to Faye. And Kupono comes through again when they need him the most.
Or twice he's been called upon to stop the bleeding, and he's been successful, as you said, both times. Crucial kills for Kupono Faye and Hawaii.
We saw Hawaii late in the match last night go to Kupono in some crucial situations as well, and he delivered. Here's Joe Worsley, the 6-foot sophomore, to serve for Hawaii. 22-19 in the first. Tickles the tape. Rattled around and returned. Free chance here for Hawaii. Jennings, middle set, to Mol! Straight down to the floor.
Oh, and Eric Chance knew that ball was being sent to Mol, so he committed on him, tried to get a block, and instead, Mol just too quick a jump, too quick an arm swing. big point for Hawaii to get that four-point spread once again.
Yeah, significantly more comfort in this four-point advantage, 23 serving 19. Middle set, that's chance. One-hand dig by Worsley. Faye sets up Rosenmeier. That's saved by Green from the back row.
Lillithorpe makes a great swing at this, but there's Mol. He's got two other guys right next to him. Six hands across for that Hawaii block. Block number four on the night, the two for CSUN.
Aloha ball in the first for Hawaii. Set goes outside to Kulchev. Sends it long. No touch. And after CSUN threatens and gets it to within two, Hawaii ends the opening stanza on a 4-0 run. They take it 25-19, and the fourth-ranked team in the land strikes first on senior night.
Big Island Candies, the perfect place to find the perfect gift. Visit them at their flagship store in Hilo, at Ala Moana Center, or online at BigIslandCandies.com to see their amazing selection, including delicious chocolate dip shortbreads.
Hendrik Mol, he was the man in that opening stanza. Four kills, no errors. C-Mac hitting 667.
Well, good numbers for Hendrik. Normally, your middle blocker is not your kill leader. Usually, it's one of your outsides, one of your pin hitters. Instead, Hendrik Mol made the most of the six sets that he got.
Also had an emphatic stuff that helped spark Hawaii's 4-0 run to close the opening set. Series record sponsored by Aston Hotels and Resorts. Hawaii tacking on another victory last night in straight sets. They have now won the last seven meetings between these two teams.
So Hawaii going back to their starting lineup. As we predicted, I think Charlie Braid really wants to have those six starters that have been playing so well together over the last month and a half, 2 months. Let's get them back in the groove, back getting some good MPSF competition together. And so Stein has been re-entered into the lineup. Stein Van Kilper.
Thought it was a really great gesture, though, to put Iain McKellar the starting lineup. He got to get the introduction prior to the match, right? And I guess Charlie actually asked him. He said, hey, look, what's more important to you?
Yeah.
Playing at the beginning of the match, playing at the end of the match? He said, the beginning. Yeah. Because of the intro, of course.
Absolutely.
And he was able to collect a kill and a block in his family.
There's his mom.
In the house, John Carroll and his brother Chris in the middle.
Yeah, what an exciting time for them. That was pretty awesome. Classy move by Charlie, and a little bit risky move by Charlie Wade, knowing that he's got to win. Yeah, you know, he's got to win tonight, and he's going to split with UCLA at least, or lose tonight and then sweep UCLA.
There's Jennings on the second touch again, third time he's done that tonight. He's one of the top hitters in this match so far for Hawaii.
Boy, the Millos, you know, they really don't get set that much, but right now he's getting more sets than anybody else except for Kupono Faye. Kupono Faye's got nine sets. Hendrik Mol's got seven.
One serving zero. Backside. It's Kulchev. And he goes off the block and out. Yeah, you know, you mentioned Charlie risking a little bit, perhaps, with the new starting lineup in that first set. And he stayed with it. Hawaii had built an 8-point lead. It looked like they were cruising. It was 20 serving 12. And then all of a sudden, CSUN was within two. And instead of making a change, he stuck with it, and they were able to come through.
That was actually pretty cool. I was really, I'm really happy for Iain to be winning by playing an entire set and not being pulled at 21-19 or 22-20, whatever it was. What a great young man.
Oh, he's one
spent
of the best.
Spent a whole year rehabbing. I was here a lot that year, and he was in the training room every single day rehabbing a knee that got operated on. It's really kind of a sad thing seeing him hurt so badly. Oh, again.
Hendrik is a beast here tonight on senior night so far. Second block for him.
Great timing, good commit move. You can tell the ball's going to the middle. He knows that Chance, you know, has had a really good run last night and tonight, so he's going to be paying a lot of attention to him. Unfortunately, he's also going to worry about Arvis Green on the right side.
Bay into the net. But what, just like last night, avoiding any service errors in the opening set, but then they had a whole bunch of them in the second stanza last night.
I think they had at least six last night in that second set.
There's Chance with the serve, two-handed by Tuileta. Backside, it's Von Tilburg with his first swing. And of course, it's a kill. So if you're CSUN and head coach Jeff Campbell, Hawaii is able to build an 8-point lead on you in the opening set. Yes, give your team credit. They were able to forge a comeback, but ultimately it was a 6-point loss in the first. And then Charlie put Stein Von Tilburg in.
I know. It's like, it's psychologically, it's got to be working a little bit on this CSUN team that Hawaii's arguably the best player sits out the first and they still lose. And now, here he comes. Dalton Solberg getting a chance to play as well. Looks like he's going to play in place of maybe Gassman.
Pipe set goes to Faye. Diving save by Suarez. Second touch dump shot by Byers. And they work it to Solberg. Dalton Solberg, the 6'6 soft from Lindenhurst, Illinois. Immediate offense.
Dalton Solberg, what a great story by him. He turned down Harvard, by the way, to come to the University of Hawaii. Loves their oceanography program. What a play by Suarez. He did an amazing job last night with 9 digs. Now just a great diving save. And here's Solberg finishing it off. Jennings, Franciskovic getting him involved right away.
And Solberg participating in his 16th match of the season. Middle set, Byers. What a dig by Tui. Rosie launches cross court and in. Oh, that was a quick reset for Rosenmeier. Was able to spring right back up, but what a dig by that guy right there.
Great dig by Tuileta. Keep this rally alive. Pops it up, and at the end of the play, Hawaii had three blocks. CSUN had a great block, well formed, and Rosie just took a little bit off that cross-court swing.
Hawaii by 3. That goes to Green, soft touches it over. Jennings outside to Rosenmeier again, and this time he didn't take anything off.
And Tuileta again with the key dig to get that play started.
And a timeout taken by the Matadors. Hawaii off and running again in the second. Welcome back. Let's check out the First Hawaiian Bank top three. NCAA service aces and Dimitar Kalchev of CSUN, far and away the ace leader in the country. He now has 61, had 2 last night. But a whole lot of service errors, and even tonight hasn't quite looked as dominant as he usually is behind the service line.
Exactly, and part of that is that Hawaii's passers have really done a good job of putting his serves up.
Here's Green from the back row, puts it down up over the top of that block. But, you know, a lot of it for Dimitar Kalchev is when a guy revs it up and fires missiles the way he does, you have to live with the service errors.
Exactly.
He serves at about 75% is the metric on him. And so, you know, you live and die by that sometimes.
Exactly. He misses about 1 out of every 4. Last night he had 6 service errors. Unusual for him to have that many errors.
Outside, Rosenmeier.
Jennings Franciscovich doing a nice job of getting Rosenmeier a one-on-one situation. CSUN's middles that time, Josiah Byers committing on Hawaii's middle attacker there.
Rosie appeared in 19 matches as a frosh last year, but has really emerged here, making his 15th start tonight. In 2017 is one of Hawaii's go-to players. And Jennings Franciskovic does it again, solo style, on Dimitar Kalchev.
And this is the matchup Charlie Wade wanted. He wanted to have Jennings Franciskovic, with that great leaping ability of his, matched up on Kalchev. Charlie got his wish.
9th solo block of the season for Franciskovic. 9 serving 4. Kalchev the pass. He gets the set on the outside. The touch shot right there is Stein. Jennings, jump set to Faye. Oh, it's all working right now for Hawaii.
Once again, Jennings Franciskovic taking 2 blockers with him on that pass. Close to the net, he pretended like he was going to be an attacker. Instead, he was a setter, took 2 guys with him, leaving Kupono Faye with only 1 blocker. A hitter's dream.
4 kills now for Faye. He was hitting negative numbers just a little while ago, now up to 182. Kalchev again, big swing. And misses the court wide. The call is a point for Hawaii. And Jeff Campbell, I think, will challenge. And I think he is challenging the in-out call, and so Dan Hiranaka will take a look at things. He is the down official, Bill Forrester atop the ladder. Dean Tamura and Bert Kasem are the line judges.
Tamura made the call, and Bill Forrester looked over at him and said that he agreed that he was following the ball as well, and he thought that the linesman got it right, and that's why he gave Hawaii the point. Now Dan Hiranaka will see if he can see a convincing evidence that that ball was in.
And again, challenging from what we understand, the in-out call, not a touch on the block. It was awfully close, that's for sure.
Well, Kalchev hits the ball so hard. He hits it about, you know, probably, he hits his spikes probably, you know, over 70 miles an hour. It's hard to slow the ball down.
It looks in to me.
That looks good to me, yeah. I think Campbell might win this challenge.
And it is going to be a point for CSUN. So good work on the part of the Matadors. Dimitar Kalchev staring through the net and applauding the reversal of the call. He knows how to poke and prod a little bit against the opposition.
He does. Remember, he's a beach player, too. A lot of chatter goes on the beach as well. He's a Bulgarian under 22 national champion on the beach.
Fires the jump serve. Jennings, backside to Stein, off the block and out. Stein von Tilburg, who last night had 13 kills, hit 500, had an ace, five digs, three blocks. Just another day at the office last night for SVT.
You know what's great about Stein tonight, too? He was so supportive of Iain McKellar getting the start tonight. And nice to see that kind of attitude. That's what good teams are made of, when they support each other like that.
Solberg with the serve blasts it long. And it can be cliche sometimes when you talk about this kind of thing, but you know, there really is a strong bond with the players on this team. In a sport like volleyball, the chemistry plays so prevalently into the success or lack thereof.
Exactly. You're playing in a 30-foot by 30-foot area, too. There's six guys in a small area. And sometimes that can be not make for great chemistry. I think Jennings Franciskovic should just set Hendrik Mol every time.
Five kills on seven swings, blemish free, and there was not a blocker in sight by the time Mol made contact.
Mol did a nice job of running to the gap area, the area between the middle blocker and the outside blocker.
Fade taking a swing, and he made contact with the net, and so it's a point for CSUN. I love the way you characterize the small playing surface and all six players. I mean, it's kind of like, you know, some tight living conditions where you got a host of roommates, and you know how that can get sometimes.
We got the net cam. We'll see who touches the ball. There, oh, you know what? Pono Faye says that ball was over the net, and that was the first violation. He's not contending that he hit the net. He admits that he hit the net, but he thinks that his violation was the second violation to occur on that play.
Long discussion between the floor captain, Jennings Franciskovic, and Bill Forrester.
This ball's all the way on Kupono's side of the net. That ball is that's right there. It's really hard to tell. I think that ball probably still had at least a sliver of it still on CSUN's side. Therefore, they had a chance to play it.
And not a reviewable play, mind you. Here's Kalchev. 63 miles an hour on that serve. Back set to Faye. Had to adjust the run up and then misses wide. CSUN within four. Kalchev with those 61 aces setting a new CSUN single season record. Already has over 100 career service aces. He's just a sophomore. But misses long. So again, the give and take of a bomb server like Dimitar Kalchev. He can score, but at what cost on occasion?
Exactly. You know, Jeff Campbell's willing to take his chances. Kalchev is just a sophomore, second year in the league, and Jeff knows that Kalchev is just going to get better and better as he ages in this league.
Free swing for Rosie on the overpass. And Hawaii up a half dozen.
Give the credit to Kupono Faye even more than Rosemeyer. And Rosemeyer had the easy job. He just jumped up, tapped it down. Kupono Faye's the one who forced the passer to pass it over the net.
Into the net it goes to Faye.
What is it about second set this weekend for the servers for Hawaii?
It's that side of the court, I guess.
I don't know. It's six errors last night in the second set. Tonight, already three errors.
Here's the serve by Chance. Middle set, Mole off the block. Rosie pops it up over the net. And green skies to put that one down. So 10 serving 14.
We'll these guys, Arvis, let's go.
Matadors grouping together to try to share some words of encouragement here. They have proven to be a resilient bunch, but yeah. You know, the losses have been piling up. They've now lost seven straight matches here coming into tonight, and after a while, that starts to mess with your mind a little bit.
You know, I watched them on TV when they got down 0-2 to UCLA and then came back to win 3-2. That was one of the highlights of the year, showing Jeff Campbell they're as good as any team in the league, because UCLA was picked to be in the top three in the league, maybe top three in the country. So that was a big win for them, but they have not been able to put together an effort like that recently.
Rosenmeier off of Chance, chased down by Kalchev, couldn't get there. Hawaii hits 15 first. Immediate timeout. Welcome back. UH fans, select your exact seat locations when purchasing individual game tickets at HawaiiAthletics.com. Click on the tickets button to print your tickets. You can avoid the lines by going online. So Hawaii up five here on CSUN. They took the first set 25-19. The Rainbow Warriors setting a new program record with that sweep win last night over the Matadors. They've now won 20 home matches in a row dating back to last year. And they can finish the home schedule in the regular season unbeaten if they close the deal tonight. And Hendrik Mol is doing everything he can to contribute to that.
Yeah, he's got the wrong thing in the front of his shirt. It should be an S in the front of his shirt, don't you think? Forget the number 8. Just put a big S there. He's blocking. He's digging. He actually, I think he had an assist earlier. He's got an ace now.
He's stepping it up here on senior night.
And the roll shot.
Backside set, it's green. Touched there by Rosenmeier. So Faye sets up Stein cross court, one-handed in the air by Lilithorpe. Lilithorpe will two-hand it over the net. One-hand set, but Solbrig hits it wide. You may have noticed, by the way, Chris, it was something that occurred within all of the action, but for the last few sequences, Skylar Lilithorpe took over the setting responsibilities for the Matadors. Now you have the starting center, Sam Porter, in and back to serve.
Exactly, and Parker Mackey has also come in to play in that outside pin position.
There's Rosenmeier. Goes off of Kalchev.
How about Rosie with 8 kills, leading everybody on the court right now? 8 kills, 1 error, hitting about 600.
What does he think this is, sophomore night?
I know. But what a great career he's had here at UH, building, working his way up to a starting position.
Porter now back at the setter spot. Back sets two. The aforementioned Parker Mackey, 6'5 freshman from Newberry Park, California. And he misses the court. So largest lead here of this second set for Hawaii. And after a few moments to ponder, Jeff Campbell signals for a timeout. So we'll keep things here. Let's check in with Ryan Kalei-Suji.
Hey, thanks, Kano. We are here in the stands. Earlier, we talked to some of the other moms. Right now, we have Shelly Faye joining us here. Shelly, talk to us about what these 4 years have been like watching your son play here at home.
It's been awesome just to have family and friends come out and watch and fill the stadium. It's been so exciting.
You know, earlier in the broadcast, we actually did a story on Kupono, and he kind of shared about it, but he's part of this generation, this legacy, if you will, of your family. But what does it mean to kind of see him sort of carry that out and really fulfill that kind of that legacy that you and your father played here?
I think it's been exciting for him to be able to feel that heritage, but at the same time, he's really making his own
legacy. Really, he's done a lot more. There's never so much media attention on the games and activities here, so he's really doing a lot for himself, and he's setting it up for his own legacy.
And we see a lot of support here, a lot of Kupono shirts in this time. How many people are here? I know your husband Kyle's also here, but you have a lot of other family members and friends here.
Yeah, we got my mom's nieces, the Chinese side, and we got my cousins, the Kahuanui family are out in the stands, and they're going to put on a little bit of a show during senior night. Got some cousins that are going to be out there on the floor doing some special performance, so it's going to be a fun night.
Going to be a fun night indeed. Thank you so much, Shelly. We'll send it back over to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. We look forward to that. And yeah, when you're with some of the Fei and Kahuanui family, you are among greatness, that is for sure. And Kupono is the latest in that lineage. And what I really appreciate is what Shelly said in the piece in the pregame about just how he has grown. I mean, this is not just a sports or athletic endeavor for these student athletes. This is a journey into manhood and into adulthood.
Exactly. One of the things he did to further that growth was to go play with the USA youth national team and junior national teams. I think that matured him a lot too as he traveled around the world. Sure. Made a big difference. He became a leader on those teams, and he brought that leadership component back to this UH program.
And he also represents something that Charlie Wade would love to see more of, and that is a local product and prospect staying home and playing for the University of Hawaii in seasons like this, where Hawaii is among the elite in the national rankings, currently fourth, third in the vaunted MPSF conference. These seasons may prove to be motivation for some of the future prospects to maybe give Hawaii a further consideration.
Exactly. And the better Hawaii gets, the more the local boys will stay home.
And it's Lily Thorpe hitting once again, this time going off the block and out. Kupono Fei saying, I mean, imagine all of the talent that comes out of these islands. If you can get just a handful of them to stay here at the University of Hawaii, I mean, you're talking about a team that would be pretty darn formidable.
Exactly.
Just with the Hawaii guys alone. Here's Jennings outreaching everybody on that jump.
He just elevates on that, makes it really difficult for the middle blocker to know where exactly he's going to go, because when he goes up with two hands like that, he can twist and turn and put the ball anywhere he wants. Goes up and looks, finds the open space, taps it down.
So Hawaii built an 8-point lead in the first set. They're up 7 here in the second. Back set goes to Lily Thorpe, and he clobbers it off of the block and out. So Skylar Lily Thorpe showing some of his versatility tonight. He is second on the team in assists, so he is the de facto backup setter, but also moving to setter and back to hitter with frequency.
Yeah, he may be, you know, Coach Campbell loves him. He's maybe the most versatile guy on the team. He's the backup outside, backup opposite, backup center, and backup libero. He does it all.
And ironically, he has started the last two nights. As that one is sent long. Of course, their team captain, Jacob Chesla, missing tonight's match as well as last night's because of a shoulder injury. And Coach Campbell saying, you know, it was kind of unfair what we did to Skyler last night, because literally a minute before the match started, we said, by the way, you're in the starting lineup.
I was watching Jacob warm up, and he really looked good. And then I think he swung a little bit too hard on one of his swings, and just did not, just didn't feel right, I guess. And so he came back and said, Coach, take me out of the starting lineup. But, Coach is really looking forward to having Jacob in there, because he has been their leader. He's their old, experienced guy that is the missing piece right now, says Jeff Campbell.
Yeah, especially for all of this sort of young and molded talent. A lot of former basketball players. Jeff Campbell saying, you know, we still have a ways to go in terms of the collective volleyball IQ on the team. And another out serve by Dimitar Kalchev. So we haven't been able to really enjoy the full extent of Kalchev's talent at scoring from behind the service line. He just hasn't been locked in here this weekend.
Yeah.
At least not yet. Backside, here's Green. High hands, played by Fei. Hawaii getting a lot of touches up front. Rosenmeier, too hot for Kalchev to handle. And it's another point for Hawaii. And look at this score, Chris.
Look at Rosie light up the numbers on the scoreboard himself. 9 kills, 1 error, hitting 615. a young man from the same hometown as Josh Walker, Virginia Beach. Two-time Virginia State Player of the Year.
Lillithorpe back at center. Here's Green. Block got a piece again. Layout saved by Faye. Stein, hard angle. Good dig there by Green. Outside, the hit by Mackey. And he gets the point for CISA.
Every time I see a ball go just over the bench like that, I think of Eric Kalima back in the old days. He doesn't care if the bench is there. He doesn't care about press row. He leaps right over. It was just unbelievable. He did that one time. I'll never forget it. Everybody was worried that we'd have to take him to the hospital, but he just landed, bounced back up, jumped over the press table, and came back and played. I'm sure glad that Kupono Faye thought better of that. Boy, needs him too much against the rest of this night and in the two matches against UCLA next week.
Yeah, while admirable, that type of fearlessness sometimes isn't the smartest. You're right.
Middle set. Mol goes off the block and down. And Josiah Byers making a gesture like, what can we do?
That's a big stop hit. Hendrik Mol, 6 kills in one area. He needed about 500.
So he's hitting 500. Rosie's hitting 615. Jennings Franciskovic has 4 kills for crying out loud.
And he's hitting 1,000.
Oh, boy.
Ooh, where'd
that 69 come from? Mile an hour serve, but he misses wide. That was on a Aloha ball here for the second set.
That was a little bit of show off.
He was trying to go out in style there.
Yeah. he brought so much there. My goodness gracious.
Jarvis Green now to serve. Still Aloha ball here in the second for Hawaii. Jennings high and away. Rosenmeier gets it in, hard angle. And on his 10th kill of the night, Hawaii secures set 2. They take it 25-17. They're up 2-0. And they have a chance to open up the broom closet on senior night. Welcome back. Time to check out the McDonald's match statistics. What stands out to you, C-Mac?
Not a great offensive night for either team. Hawaii normally hits around 320. They're below their average, but they're 160 points above CSUN. And CSUN normally hits right around 320 as well. Hawaii with 6 blocks to 2. That's significant. Hawaii's pretty much dominated at the net. Hawaii also about dominated the back row, 19 digs to 13. And I would have expected there to be more aces for CSUN, but instead, Hawaii's had the better of it in the ace department. So go figure.
This represents this set, I think, from the perspective of the Matadors, a bit of a gut check time, right? They are not yet mathematically out of the postseason hunt. We'll see a lot about what they're made of, I think, here in this situation, down 2 sets to none.
Exactly. That window is getting smaller and smaller because I think if they lost tonight, it'd be really tough to come back and get. They need eight wins, 7 if they get tonight and against you said against Long Beach, that'd be 7 wins. I think 8 is what's going to get in. So I think it's mathematically going to be tough.
The question is, what kind of lineup are we looking at here for Hawaii? And it looks as though it is the traditional starting lineup that we have seen here over the majority of the season, with Stein von Tilburg out there. And Gassman back in there in middle as well.
Yeah. But back to CSUN, you know, I tell you this, they will not give up. You know, they're a well-coached team that will be scrappy and fight. They're not happy, I'm sure, that they've lost 5 straight sets to the University of Hawaii.
Meanwhile, Hawaii would like nothing better than to close it out here in the third. Franciskovic serves it out to start set 3 and then get on to the senior celebration.
You know, they also, CSUN also knows that they had 2 of the sets they could have won last night. Tonight, neither set was close, but they had 2 out of 3 sets last night that went to overtime.
This is the first lead for CSUN in any of the sets tonight. Stein von Tilburg, solo block by Arvis Green. And so the Matadors starting off the third with some positivity.
Told you they wouldn't give up. They're playing scrappy right away. 2-0. Finger wag. Minute ball. You were thinking about Minute, weren't you?
Oh, yeah. Mount Matumbo.
Mr. Automatic, we'll call it. Just another night at the office for Hendrik Mol. 7 kills now, 1 error, hitting the mirror. Oh, 545.
Unbelievable. Taking it to another level here on senior night. Here's Faye with the serve. Set goes high and away. Kolchev, the tough shot, and Jennings couldn't get there.
Kolchev does not tip that much. He likes to hammer, so he must have seen something in Jennings Franciskovic hanging deep, waiting to get the dig. And so that tip shot successful. Smart play.
And one of the storylines tonight, Kolchev with some fairly pedestrian numbers by his standards as Rosenmeier continues to go to work. He's locked in. That's his 11th kill. He's hitting up near 700.
Big numbers for Rosie, who has struggled a bit this year sometimes in his consistency and throwing away some, you know, some sloppy hits here and there to bring his average down. But tonight, very consistent.
Well, even last night, we saw Charlie Wade go to Austin Mataltia for a time in the match. Faye goes cross-court to Stein. Winds up, uncoils. Great dig there by Porter. So Suarez sets up Green! But a net violation against Hawaii.
I think Rosie got caught up in the net. Might have been Gaston running into him, I'm not sure.
Yeah, wipes off what would have been another rainbow roof. So 4-2 here coming up for CSUN. And we saw this last night. A lot of pauses in the action to wipe perspiration off of the court. And I was talking with one of the towel girls saying, hey, you guys went to work. And a lot of it was, as you take a look at the net violation there, Rosenmeier on the bottom of it just kind of losing his balance. And you're right, maybe it was because Gassman kind of bumped into him.
Gassman's a large human being. Are you aware of that?
I've heard. So I was asking the towel girl, I said, they put you to work last night. And it was the libero Suarez who sort of kept asking for perspiration to get wiped off. She says, yeah, he's kind of like a slug. With all of the sweat that was accumulating on his jersey. And, of course, he's diving all over the floor as CSUN once again making its presence felt here at the net. There is C.J. Suarez.
He's got 6 digs tonight. He averages about 2 digs per set. Last night he had 9 digs, so he averaged over 3 digs a set last night.
Charlie not happy about that last sequence. He's given an earful to Dan Hironaka, who then walks across court to speak with Bill Forrester. Not exactly sure what Charlie saw, although he was on it on a couple of the arguments last night, and in fact had a couple of positive reviews and replay challenges.
On your side only. We're good.
What if Bill Forrester was saying, chill with the trash talks? Maybe that was part of it.
There was quite a bit going on, especially down the stretch last night.
Yeah.
Middle set, it's Gassman, he's blocked and roofed. Another solo job by Eric Chance. And it's a 3-0 run for CSUN, largest lead for the Matadors in this match.
They're committing pretty much every time Hawaii gets a good pass. Middle blockers are committing on Hawaii's middle attackers. And so the best set really is to go to the outside quickly on a fast tempo to get a one-on-one situation. And Jennings Franciskovic has kind of gone away from that. He was doing it earlier. Now he's trying to reestablish the middle. We'll see if Chance commits again on the next good Hawaii pass.
So one of the few stretches of true adversity here for Hawaii tonight. Green with the serve. Tuileta handles the pass. Pipe set goes to Faye. Right there is Suarez. Kolchev against the double block. Tools it to his edge. And CSUN with 4 consecutive points. They now lead by 5. Charlie Wade wants to see no more. He signals for a timeout. Welcome back. Time to check out how it works, presented by Central Pacific Bank. Chris.
Jennings Franciskovic has become a much more offensive player. Watch him go up high at the net, twist and turn, put it down with 2 hands, He's now 4-for-4 on shots like this. That's how you become an offensive setter, with shots like that.
But Hawaii finds itself trailing by 5 here in the third. Backside goes to Stein, and he is roofed. And CSUN right now has put up an impenetrable wall in this third set.
See, if I'm Hawaii, I'm thinking, wow, this is really cool. We got to play from behind now. We've been getting spoiled by being ahead all the time and had all these sweeps at home. All of a sudden, we're behind at home. Let's see how they respond.
Jennings goes middle. Gassman. And the ball is in, although the entire Matador bench came running out from their seated position and the bench area, proclaiming that head coach Jeff Campbell needs to review that. And so he does challenge the play.
The second one tonight, he'll have one more left. Unlike the international situation where if you successfully challenge, you don't lose your challenges.
Let's take a look here. Might be tough from this angle. Looks it in from
pretty,
that angle.
Look pretty good, yeah. It was a good call. As it slowed down, you'll see on the replay that you'll see a lot of brown Terraflex. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's clearly
that
in.
Looks pretty conclusive right
clearly,
there.
Clearly in.
And so it is a point for Hawaii. A much-needed point, mind you. Rainbow Warriors running away with the first two sets. We were commenting during the commercial break, though, Chris. You said, you know, even though Hawaii has put together a lot of sweeps here at home in MPSF play, it is hard to beat an MPSF opponent 3 straight sets. It's even harder to beat them 6 straight sets,
yeah,
as Hawaii is attempting to do here with the Matadors. Here's Kalchev. Somehow got that through the Hawaii block. And the Rainbow Warriors appear to have come out flat here in this third set.
Look what happened to BYU today. BYU wins last night 3-2 in 5. And then the very next day, Long Beach reverses it on them.
Sweeps them
3-0.
Which means that Long Beach State holds the tiebreaker between the two. And that's an ace from Kalchev. And all of a sudden, CSUN feeling its groove, and Dimitar Kalchev firing one of his rocket service aces.
He shows why he is the leading acer in the country.
It's now 62 on the year. 62 aces. Outside. Rosenmeier. Why not? He's had the hot hand all night long.
I think you'll see Franciskovic go more to the outside now, because the pretty much CSUN's committing right there in the middle every time, going up with Hawaii's middle attackers, which leaves the pin hitters with only one blocker. And Hawaii and CSUN's shortest blocker to boot, 6'3", Sam Porter.
Hawaii playing from behind. Here it comes from Rosenmeier. Outside, Louis Thorpe off the block of Jennings Franciskovic, and out. That was an opportunity there. Louis Thorpe didn't get a good touch on that. Just enough, though.
Olythorpe now with 4 kills. Kalchev and Green leading with 7 kills apiece, and Hawaii's Rosenmeier leading with 12.
Jennings, D-set to Stein. Goes off of the shoulder of Chansenow.
Little chin music that you baseball players would say. Or shoulder music. This arrives in a hurry. Can't get out of the way. They gave him the line, and he took it with authority.
3 kills now for Stein. Gassman the serve. Suarez with the perfect pass. Middlesex goes to Byers. And all of a sudden, there is a pep in the step of the CSUN Matadors. After the first two sets, you could see a lot of doubt pervading through the rotation out on the floor.
And I think we both agreed that this is a scrappy team, you know, who was denied a couple of wins last night. They're not gonna stop tonight until the last whistle blows, I'll tell you that.
Block gets a touch on Stein there. Here's Lily Thorpe against a triple block. Rattled around. Free ball coming here for Hawaii. Jennings outside to Faye. Well, he's still with a pretty tall hill to climb in this third set.
Tall order to come back from 12-4. We'll see if they can do it.
Franciskovic will serve. Leads the team with 18 service aces coming into tonight. Already has one ace in this match. Lilythorpe is blocked back. Lilythorpe a second time blocked and rooted. Guess who, Chris? Hendrik Mol again.
Superman, like I said, put an S in the front of his shirt. And the roof towels come out. The Rainbow Roofing Company has punched in.
See that one? A big spot right there? Yeah.
That's a great, well-formed block. A lot of work by Hendrik Mol to get to the outside. Such a difficult job those middle blockers have to cover so much territory. You know, the outside blockers, they've got a couple steps, they go to the outside to get the antenna. Meantime, Mole's got to go pretty much antenna to antenna.
He's already got the volleyball version of the Clark Kent glasses.
Yes, so he does. You're right.
I guess the Superman theme.
Are there any other players in the country that can get up as high as Green in terms of he touches 12-1?
Ben Patch.
Would that be the other?
Ben Patch
of BYU?
Definitely. And probably the only other one.
I would imagine so. I mean, just freaky hops that those two players
exactly,
have.
Exactly. Great pass by Tuileta.
Stein, touch shot is blocked, and Hawaii just wasn't ready for that ricochet. That was Green.
You know, there's an example of how Hawaii sometimes can get a little complacent when Stein goes up to hit because they're so used to him putting him down and terminating. He's human. He's going to get blocked once in a while, so you better cover him every single time.
Lilythorpe misses wide. Ill-timed service error there for CSUN. And now Kupono Fay retreats back behind the service line. Momentum can get away from you pretty quickly in this game.
It's a huge game of momentum.
Kalchev pops it straight up. So out of system play here. Kalchev, though, rights the ship. And CSUN, for the first time in this series, reaches 15 first. And they're smiling. They're hopeful and encouraged. Despite being down 2-0. Welcome back. A stoic Charlie Wade out of the timeout.
CSUN hitting 583 in the set. Hawaii 067. CSUN siding out at 88%. Hawaii at 50. There's the difference.
And here's Byers on the serve. Tuileta, perfect pass. Jennings goes middle to Mol. The set was a little low, but it still made it work. Porter laying out for the dig, but it finds its way out of play. So Hawaii scores out of the break. It is 9 serving 15. They got some work to do, but it's Hendrik Mol retreating back behind the line.
Hendrik Mol with his 8th kill, hitting 583. About 150 points above his season average. Having a huge night.
Goes down the line and wide. And he stares off into the distance for a moment, wondering what happened on that service attempt.
I wonder if that thumb is bothering him at all as far as ball control is concerned. He jammed his thumb earlier this week, and it's got it all taped up. It's got to affect somehow his touch.
16 serving 9. How about that serve? Speaking of touch by Green, middle set Gassman. It caught a piece of Green before finding its way out.
Haven't seen that serve in a long time, or maybe ever.
That was pretty unorthodox.
That was the longest tip shot I've ever seen.
He basically dinked it from the service line.
I think what happened was he had a bad toss. He had to save it.
Outside, Kalchev. Jennings made a decent adjustment on the block, but Kalchev was still able to thread the needle.
Kalchev has really turned his game around. Earlier, he was 4 kills, 4 errors, hitting 0-0-0. Now, he's got 9 kills, and he's hitting 333, more like his normal season average.
61-mile-an-hour serve. Rosenmeier the pass, Rosenmeier the swing, and that one popped up by Suarez. Here's Lily Thorpe. Two-handed in the air by Tui. That's a bump set out to Rosie. High hand, Suarez off the ricochet. Backside, it's Green rising up off the block. He handles his own save. Here's Lily Thorpe on the opposite side. Jennings, D-set to Stein. Diving save, Kalchin. Suarez lays out to get the second touch and a free chance here for Hawaii on a long sequence. Can Stein terminate? No, he can't. Dug up back over the net by Kalchin. Jennings, high and away, Rosenmeier. Off the block, Lily Thorpe, the tip right there is Tui. Rosenmeier again, the touch shot, diving save, Green. And then missing the floor from the middle position was Eric Chance. Can you believe that?
Maybe the rally of the year. Tui Lehto, three tremendous digs. CSUN, great digging in the back row. And this arena goes nuts. They loved it. The bench loved it. Charlie Wade might be the only guy who's not smiling right now. Everybody else is smiling. They played volleyball.
That was epic.
It really was.
And strangely, it ended with Eric Chance, who did not commit a hitting error last night at all, missing a wide open floor.
Of all people. His first error in two nights.
The kind of play, dare we say, that can spark a change in momentum. Crowd getting a little more involved.
Coming back from six, it's still going to be a big challenge.
What a pass by Suarez. Lily Thorpe, oh, he put a little extra mustard on it. And a huge fist pump in celebration. So much for that momentum shift.
Lily Thorpe starting to get used to the outside hitting position. Remember last night he was thrown into it in the last minute. And Jacob Chesler could not quite get his shoulder to work right. And so Skyler struggled a little bit early, and then later on he was playing quite well at the end of that match. And tonight he's picking up where he left off.
Yeah, a little more mentally prepared to play tonight, as you can imagine. Jennings outside to Kupono. Faye. Cross-courted in. Faye with his sixth kill. Hawaii hasn't been able to close the distance here in the third. Joe Worsley now in and back to serve.
They give CSUN credit every time Hawaii starts to make a run. CSUN gets an important side out and extends their lead.
CSUN hit 421 in this set. Hawaii hitting 167. Lily Thorpe off the block and out. And right now he's got the hot hand. He hit triple zeros last night. Tonight now he has six kills and he's up near 200.
Big change in 24 hours for Lily Thorpe. Well, last night, three kills, three errors, hit 0-0-0.
How about that back set to Stein Suarez? And it's going to be a point for Hawaii. That set from Jennings, cross court to Stein, was pretty incredible.
It was a thing of beauty. Not easy to do, and it was right on the money. Stein actually, I think, was a little late getting a run on it because he didn't think that Jennings could set it that far.
And Tilburg, meanwhile, four kills on 14 swings, three errors. He's hitting 0-7-1, so one characteristic numbers for him. And it's an ace by Jennings Franciskovic, his second of the night. And Hawaii within a handful.
The ace towels come out. Good swing by Jennings there. As Suarez has really passed the ball pretty well over the last couple nights. Has been ace much. Hawaii hasn't gotten any aces the last couple nights.
Backside, here's Lily Thorpe, has the hot hand. Jennings, though, off the ricochet with the save. Here's Stein, triple block up. Dug up by Kalchev. Porter bump sets, Green touches it over. Tui, to his former Punahou mate, Kupono Faye. The two Puffin Blue graduates combining forces on another Hawaii point.
You guys had a couple of state championships together, and now all of a sudden Hawaii down four.
And a timeout by the Matadors will keep things here. So the Rainbow Warriors trying to make it a little more interesting as they lead in this match two sets to none. But it has been all Matadors so far in the third.
I'll tell you, in the big picture, as a coach, this is really good. If they go out and win three straight both nights, Charlie Wade's really not getting to see what the team's really made of. to see adversity here and have to face, you know, a big deficit, have to come back and battle back, I think is going to make this team better than had they won three straight and won easily.
While we have a break in the action, let's check in with Ryan Kalesuji.
Hey, thanks, Kunal. Ponofe really showing a lot of emotion on the Hawaii sideline earlier in this timeout. He was emphatically yelling at his team, saying, we have got to finish, we've got to play better defense, we've got to go after every single ball. Head coach Charlie Wade talking to his team about the importance of taking their time behind the service line. He thinks Hawaii is getting far too easy in their serves. He wants to see more pressure added. And of course, we talked about it last night, the blocking assignments. Head coach Charlie Wade really spending time talking to these blockers about their hand positioning over the net. Back over to you.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. And that's something that Charlie actually praised his team for doing last night, executing some of the adjustments they talked about and worked on throughout the week. Maybe tonight, a bit of a departure, at least in this third set, from some of that.
Exactly. Part of that is from the fact that I think CSUN is hitting smarter. They're attacking Hawaii in the right places. Getting better location sets.
But Hawaii hoping for a comeback here. 15 serving 19 out of the timeout. Here's Green off the block and out. 9 kills for Green. He and Kalchev matching each other's kill output. It's 20 serving 15. And we can expect a lot of battles between these two programs as they will both make the transition to the Big West Conference next year. Backside, Faye winds up and on courts one.
We talked about Ryan Tsuji telling us about what Charlie Wayne was saying in the timeout and what Kupono Faye was saying in the timeout. Well, if he's going to be yelling at everybody to go for every ball, he's going to call upon himself to also wrap it up, which he did just then. Great senior leadership.
Got a good line going. Faye, 8 kills, 3 assists, 4 digs, and 2 blocks. And here he is to serve. Backside, Green. My goodness.
Green, once again, hitting inside the 3-meter line. That's such a sharp angle. So few people can actually really do that with authority. Green's the sky. He goes up and, as we said before, touches 12-1. Still a raw power, still young as a volleyball player.
Overpass, Kalchev, free swing, free point for CSUN.
We got that big lead again, 6-point lead, which they've had most of this third set.
You know, getting back to Green, though, you said he's still fairly raw as Charlie Wade signals for a timeout. And some of that development thwarted by the fact that he battled injury the previous 2 seasons. And so he hasn't really been able to log the full season experiences that he otherwise would have the last 2 years.
Exactly. I think he has some knee issues going on, and but he's much, much healthier this year. And certainly his numbers are proving that he's got All-American, at least All-MPSF numbers that he's putting up every night, night in and night out. He's really fun to watch, too. He's a highlight reel.
We got a baseball score from Les Murakami Stadium. 3-2, Hawaii on top in the bottom of the 7th, trying to make it 3 straight wins over San Jose State.
We'll be finishing earlier tonight, too. Last night, was it a marathon last night?
It went into the wee hours last night. An 8-7 decision, Hawaii fighting off a Spartan rally.
Did you see that?
That is Dave. That is true.
That is Dave. He's our star cameraman. The aunties in the corner take care of everybody, not just the players. They take care of the OC Sports crew. How about that?
What do you think of the crowd that came out for senior night tonight?
Good crowd. And so many of them got in the spirit of things and wore white.
Yeah.
Say 3,000, something like that. Not quite like Smith Fieldhouse today with Long Beach State and BYU, the number one, number two teams in the country playing.
Well, they pack them in like a sardine can over there. And out of the timeout, Byers sends it long. Of course, course, with any luck, this won't be the final match played this season in this building. Hawaii hoping to maintain standing in the top four, thus be in position to host in the MPSF quarterfinals a few weeks from now. James Anastasiadis, freshman from Huntington Beach, with the serve. Middle set. And that was blasted by Eric Chance.
Chance is so efficient in the middle. You know, he made a couple of mistakes tonight. Actually, he's only made one. Three kills, one error, and nine tries. But last night, he was phenomenal. Hit 800. And pretty much night in and night out, Jeff Campbell says that Eric Chance is steady as a rock.
Jennings backside. Here's it on Tilburg off the block. Diving save by Green. Gassman can't put it down. What a layup by Green. Kolchev obliges with the kill. And so Stein has been defended much better by CSUN here tonight. And it's now Aloha Ball in the third for the Matadors. The body language on both sides of the net has completely flipped.
Yeah.
Good serve by Green. Here's Faye from the back row.
Important for Hawaii, I think, to finish on a strong note here. Not to go meekly into the night in this third set. But boy, you got to give CSUN a lot of credit for playing so well in this third set.
Yeah, they have turned it on. This guy has particularly Kolchev, although he couldn't penetrate that Hawaii blockade. Gassman and Jennings.
Jeff Campbell, I think, is asking, do I have one timeout left? It looks like he might be taking it.
Still sitting on Aloha Ball here in the third. Maybe another point or two by Hawaii would be cause for concern.
I can see this Hawaii-CSUN rivalry really taking place in the Big West when they play in the Big West next year.
And Stein into the net, and that's how the third set comes to a close. So they'll swap sides, and it won't be a sweep. We know that. The Matadors able to show some grit. Set four coming up. Dimitar Kolchev, he has stepped it up here tonight.
Kolchev
11 kills, 333 so far. Sorry.
Yeah, he was in, goose eggs there for the first couple sets, and all of a sudden he just lit it up with probably had six kills in that set. Cross court, did it all kinds of ways. He did this a lot of speed shots as well. And Arvis Green, 10 kills now in 25 sets. He's got more sets than anybody else. He gets about one out of every three sets. He goes high, hits hard, and hits sharp, sharp angles. And an emotional leader. He loves to get his guys fired up.
So Green had 17 kills last night, hit 344. Kolchev, 12 kills, 217. Jeff Campbell, though, saying the problem was they didn't really get the typical night from Josiah Byers and even Skylar Lillithorpe, who wasn't intended to have to start, had to start last night. So he thought, okay, tonight, if we get a little bit from Byers, maybe Lillithorpe is in a better frame of mind, knowing that he was going to get run tonight, that we would be able to have a collective effort that would allow us to win. We saw that in the third set.
Exactly. You know, Josiah Byers, four kills, winner. He's now hitting 375. And Lillithorpe, six kills, three errors. He's hitting 176. But I think five of his six kills came in that last set. He really played well.
But CSUN still trails 2-1. Hawaii winning the first two sets handily, 25-19 and 17, and then totally flipping the script. We're the Matadors taking the third, 25-19. Here's Kupono Faye, double block up. It's Green and Byers.
CSUN hitting 464 in that last set, Hawaii 258. So the kill percentage numbers and efficiency on both sides was very different.
Green giving the signal to the bench. Here's Stein. That That's dug up over the net. Rosenmeier has to field it. Tight to the net. Byers and Green win the joust. And CSUN scores the first 2 points in set four, just like they did in the third. And they're all smiles right now, Chris.
They are. Some self-inflicted wounds by Hawaii as well. Not as precise as they could or should be. Credit CSUN for playing smart.
Here's Faye. Solo block up by Green. Net violation, though, called against Marcus Green. And it's a point for Hawaii. Now, an interesting plot to this match. Stein von Tilburg, four kills, hitting just 0.59, which is obviously far below his 4.01 season average. So the question is, did his not starting tonight, because Iain McKellar as a senior was put in the starting rotation, did that throw his rhythm off a little bit?
I think it may have. I don't think that he should use that as an excuse to not hit 400. Hawaii's expecting him to hit 400 every single night and make blocks like that, regardless of whether he starts or not.
And that may help get him going. Hawaii bounces back with two straight points of its own. Here's Franciskovic, good serve. High and away it goes to Green. Touch shot just over the net. Pinballed around Rosenmeier. What a play!
Oh, great scramble by the boys in the Hawaiian flags.
He saw the open deep corner and he went for it.
Very alert play by Rosie. You know, a lot of players will just two-hand face pass that ball over just to keep it in play, but Rosie, ever alert, put a little more steam on it, and that allowed it to go down and get a kill. Had he face passed it over, somebody would have gotten the dig, and the rally would have gone on. A lot of credit to the alert play of Brett Rosemeyer.
Uleta with 10 digs tonight. Entered this week 16th in the NCAA in digs per set. Middle set, Byers misses wide, and Hawaii up 4-2. And all of a sudden, the Rainbow Warriors have a few smiles on their side of the net, and it's CSUN with the more serious facial expression.
What a momentum shift, just in body language.
These are some violent swings that we are seeing here in this match. Backside, Lily Thorpe. We are seeing a different Skylar Lillithorpe tonight than we did last night.
Absolutely. He's playing with a lot more confidence. You know, just attacking more smartly and going after the block, seeing the block better, I think.
A three-time AAU All-American, played for his father, Jamie, for 4 years at Apopka High School in Florida, but he serves it into the net there. Here's Kupono Fay now to serve. One of the seniors who will be honored at the conclusion of this match. 2013 graduate of Punahou School, won two state titles there. His mom saying he was a bit of a late bloomer when it came to his volleyball career, as Green hammers it down. Kupono was primarily a basketball player throughout high school, but the volleyball thing kind of gained some heavy momentum as he was heading towards the college game.
Exactly. You know, he was really a good basketball player and a very good volleyball player as well, but volleyball really was his second sport. And once playing college volleyball, he was not in the scene.
Stein, heavy-handed.
He decided to put all his eggs in the volleyball basket, and it really paid off. He was going to play at the junior national level. Pretty amazing meteoric rise by the Kupono Fay. Stein's back, I think. What do you think?
That block may have recalibrated his focus. Six serving four. Kalchev comes swooping in, cross court and wide.
Kalchev loves that cross court angle. The only one who can really hit that sharp across court angle. And really do it with authority. Zarvis Green.
Yeah.
He could bring it down inside the 3-meter line. Kalchev's got to remember that he's only 6'4". And he's not like Green at 6'7 with a huge jump.
Jeff Campbell is challenging This is last play.
It's his third and final challenge. And I think he's kind of using that as a timeout. He knows that ball was out. But I think he's using it anyway. It's a pretty good strategy to get an extra timeout. Slow the other team down.
I tell you, CSUN.
Nygaard did the same thing from SC, remember?
He did.
What we'll call a fake challenge.
He's asking for a net violation against Hawaii.
I don't think he's
going to get it. But you're right. Maybe this is more gamesmanship than anything else.
Yeah.
But what's funny is the CSUN players, they will play the villain role in front of a hostile crowd. You had a lot of the fans who were getting a little impatient and antsy. They started to boo the fact that that play was being challenged. And the CSUN players were raising their arms saying, hey, let's raise the volume on that. We don't mind the booing.
Yeah. Yeah. Looks like they're looking at every single angle, but I don't think the net cam really was the best angle, I thought. It looks like there might have been a left-hand touch there by take a look.
Gassman got closest to it if there was a net.
Yeah, but I don't think he did. That angle there shows that he didn't.
And you don't see really any shaking of the net, at least from that angle.
No, and this is taking too long, slowing the game down too much. And this is the... that's the angle I think that he's going to probably choose. This is the angle I think that shows that there was not a touch on the net. And no shaking of the net, clean play. Looks like Dan Hironaka is going to rule, I think, in favor of Hawaii.
He says he didn't see it. It's a point for Hawaii. Seven serving four. The crowd was doing the wave during that review. Backside, here's Green. We have liftoff, but we have a denial by Pat Gassman.
Whoa, finally, there's a matchup. Gassman at 6'10 is the only guy, I think, in the arena that can touch Arvis Green, or at least get a soft touch. That time he was lucky that Arvis hit the ball a little low, and he got the stuff blocked.
Eight serving four. Backside, here's Green again against a solo block. Rosie got the touch. Faye tries to set up Stein. Roll shot right there is Lilythorpe. Here's Green a second time over the block. Dug up by Mol. Here's Von Tilburg. Off the block, Lilythorpe lays out with the save. Porter goes cross-court, Kalchev. And a net violation called against Hawaii to bring that sequence to an anticlimactic conclusion.
Pretty good defense going on there. Finally, Hawaii's got some touches on Arvis Green's attacks. And that time, I think Stein Van Tilburg got caught up in the cable.
And it will be Green back to serve. 6'7 junior from Los Angeles, California. Another update from Les Murakami Stadium. Hawaii tacking on a couple more runs in the top of the eighth. They're up 5-2.
Let's get one.
Green, who didn't play club volleyball, did play volleyball and basketball at University High School in LA. In fact, his senior year in volleyball hit 755 for the season.
Whoa, that's a big number.
High and away, Rosie, big windup. And he unloads.
Great set from good pass between left out to start things off. And then Jennings Franciscovic just puts up a money set right where Rosie likes it.
14 kills for Rosenmeier. And you got to love the sentiment here on senior night. Rosie saying, yeah, we're going to bid aloha to our seniors, but don't worry, the future is bright. As you see Chance hammering that down. That's his fourth put away.
Eric Chance did a great job of seeing the block take his wrist away shot. He said, okay, you take that away, I'm going to come back across my body and nail this. Great shot by Eric Chance.
Rosenmeier, by the way, now one kill shy of tying his career high, which he set against Lindenwood. Good pass there by Tui. Rosie gets it. Oh, and some high cheese
Dimitar Kalchev.
We're between Rosie and Mol tonight. I'm not sure who's hotter. The two of them can be wearing their S in the front of their shirts.
Kalchev putting his hands up more in defense than an actual attempt at the dig.
Yeah, when Rosie gets full contact, he can bring some major heat, to be sure.
As you mentioned earlier, though, consistency still something that he can improve in, but he ties a career high tonight with his 15th kill, and that one had an exclamation point on it.
I like the fact he's only had two errors all night long, hitting 542. That's huge.
Now with the jump serve.
Forces a bad pass.
Lily Thorpe over the double block, handled by Tuileta. Jennings tying away to Faye. Was there a touch? Yes, there was. CSUN wants a mishandle on the Jennings-Franciskovic set. Bill Forrester saying, uh-uh. And now Jeff Campbell going to argue his point. And while he does so, he signals for a timeout. Hawaii up 5 in the fourth. Welcome back. A lot of Hendrik Mol tonight. A lot of Brett Rosenmeier. Sprinkle in a good dose of Kupono Faye. And right now, Hawaii up 2-1 in the match and up 11-6 here in the fourth.
In this place in a celebratory mood, to be sure.
Yeah, ready to pop.
All the signs are out.
Rosenmeier out of the timeout, and it was a good timeout for Jeff Campbell.
It's one of these no one to serve out after a timeout, not good.
Rosenmeier with 15 kills ties a career high, and you were commenting during the break that that's a good thing. On a night where Stein von Tilburg doesn't necessarily have his best stuff, for somebody else to be able to fill the bill, that's huge for Hawaii. Kupono Faye plugs it through the proposed block by CISA. He now has 12 kills, hitting 304. Smart. He started in negative numbers tonight.
He did. Smart to hit at Sam Porter, the small blocker, and away from Josiah Byers, you know, arguably their best blocker.
Gassman. Add a little fuel injected into it. Free ball coming here for Hawaii. Oh, overpass by Rosenmeier. And a free swing for Lily Thorpe, who goes jumping around the floor.
You know who normally passes that free ball is Tuileta, and he was on the bench at the time because Gassman was serving.
Hey, right here, hey, sets up.
Rosie does not normally pass that free ball, but it was a pretty easy ball to pass. And he's kicking himself right now.
Jennings, backside. Here's Stein against the double block. What a pickup there by Suarez. Lily Thorpe, the touch shot, blocked back. Lily Thorpe a second time. Smothered by Jennings Franciskovic all by himself.
Every year, Jennings Franciskovic has become a better and better right side blocker. So much so that Charlie Wade loves to match him up against the other team's best hitter.
Wow. I mean, that's an eclipse right there. And Faye puts it off of the dome of Sam Porter.
Hawaii got an overpass of their own from CSUN. This is like a dunk.
Kupono Faye.
Straight down.
13 kills, hitting 333. And the largest lead of this fourth set for Hawaii. To the net, the back set, but nobody there. Can Hawaii take advantage? Yes, they can! Kupono Faye does it again, and Hawaii gets to 15 first in the fourth. Welcome back, Hawaii up 7 here in the fourth. Leading 2-1, they won the first two sets fairly efficiently, 25-19 and 17, and then CSUN turned things around in the third, winning that one 25-19. But it has been pretty much all Hawaii here in the fourth, trying to close it out on senior night. Still got a ways to go. Franciskovic with the out serve out of the media timeout.
Second serve out of a timeout in a row, not good. If the guy before you has done it, you certainly don't want to be the second guy to do the same thing. So Jennings, I'm sure, will learn from that.
Pass there by Tuileta. Fay against a solo block. Suarez dug it up, but it hit the scoreboard. Overhead.
Kupono Fay again, gradually bringing his numbers up. 15 kills now. Hitting 385. That's monstrous for an outside hitter. Rosemeyer hitting 542. Mol hitting 583.
Here's Green. Rosie got a touch. Oh, Stein couldn't quite secure the dig off the ricochet.
On the screen, gets this ball set off today. He just basically has a standing jump, not much of an approach. And Rosie got a nice piece of it, but Van Tilburg not ready, as you said, for the ricochet.
Here's Mol, that one blocked back by Chance. Rosie, the dink goes down. Now you heard from the CSUN bench clamoring for another miss hit on that first Hawaii touch. That is something that is judged fairly liberal.
Exactly, it is. First touches are always very liberal, even if it's coming over softly. In the old days, it had to be a hard-driven ball that you can mangle it. Now you can mangle it on the softest of the balls coming over.
That was a bullet. 67 mile an hour from Mol. Kalchev off the block. Good save, Fay over the net though. And Chance commits a net violation. And Hawaii gets the point.
He had the open court and an overset like that. Overpass. Ball should have been down for a point for CSUN. Jeff Campbell up off the bench. He may call his last timeout. We'll see. There's the net violation by Chance. Unusual for him. He does not make many errors.
Wow, after a bullet serve by Mol to start the sequence, Hawaii dodging a bullet there, and they now lead by 8 here in the fourth.
Jeff Campbell's got one timeout left. Looks like he's not going to use it quite yet.
He's pondering.
Well, there was a four wipeout, and that's why he got that. He used that as his timeout.
He was bivouacking along the sideline there. Green! Where the air is thin.
Gosh. You know, I keep thinking that ball set way too far behind him that he's not going to be able to get a hold of it and bring it down. And the next thing you know, he's bringing it down inside the 3-meter line. It's unbelievable.
And the point of contact is just so high above the surface. How about that diving layout pass by Tuileta? Here's Stein off the block. The swing by Porter. Pancake save Lilythorpe. They're going to say that it hit the floor, so give the roof to Hawaii and give the point to the Rainbow Warriors. And that is not something that can be reviewed.
Let's see if Bill Forrester got this one right, or the Liza might have called it. Oh, that's close. I think it did hit the floor, but it's hard to tell on that angle there. Difficult to tell.
Again, not a reviewable play, but I believe CSUN out of challenges.
Yes.
Anyway.
Yes. They do have one timeout left. Hawaii's got two.
19 serving 11.
Iain McKellar is hoping for a large lead here so he can sneak in as the fourth senior at the end of this set.
And Tilburg to serve. Here's Green from behind the line. And he gets kill number 14.
He's just hitting it harder and harder and higher and higher. Gets a good run up on this one. Stays behind the 3-meter line. And again, goes over the 6'10 Gasman. Go figure.
That's incredible. Kalchev tickles the tape, and it's an ace. That is ace number 2 tonight for Dimitar Kalchev, adding to his nation best total.
Hey, sets up, CJ.
You know, I think if Kalchev were to get another one, I'd call timeout. not even wait for the score to get inflated, get him out of his rhythm. Because when he gets hot, he can really bring it.
Sends that one long.
He can also hit it out. Six errors last night. Tonight, that is his fifth service error.
Rosenmeier, the sophomore, kind of stealing the show here on senior night.
He really is. Well, Mole's done his share, I would say.
Green, that was a blast.
That's unbelievable. Even he turns around and goes, man, did you guys all see that?
Yeah, his facial expression is classic. He even pressed himself on this one. Look at this.
Wow. Is that any good, folks? I can't believe I just did that. He's really fun to watch. He's going to be a good man. He's got national team potential. He's got to play more volleyball.
Menke serves it into the net. And that's a killer there. You get an explosive kill. And then the next sequence is a service error. Just kind of stymies any enthusiasm that you've built up. Joe Worsley getting ready to come in here for Hawaii. But Rainbow Warriors closing in. Of course, this being senior night, you start to think about this group of four seniors. And Iain McKellar, Hendrik Mol, Jennings Franciskovic, and Kupono Fay. Jennings joking prior to the match.
Three of them in the front row right now.
And Jennings joking prior to the match saying, I think Hendrik is going to be the first one to crack emotionally during the senior ceremony. Outside, here's Fay.
Another great dig by Suarez. Boy, he is special.
He's got 14 of those tonight, Chris. Jennings, jump set to Fay. Solo block up and a solo roof down.
Sam Porter, what a great job. Started 28 times last year. Has had some shoulder problems this year a little bit. But now he's strong again and showed it right there with a perfect block solo. It's their fifth block solo of the night for CSUN.
Out serve by the guy who made the solo stuff. I asked Charlie Wade, who do you think is the guy who's going to crack first and maybe shed that first tear of emotion here tonight on senior night?
I say Sir Iain.
Sir Iain?
That's my guess.
Charlie went with Jennings, this guy right here. Pass back over the net. Middle set, Mol, dug up by Suarez. That's his 15th scoop. Jennings able to deliver on the dig there. Here's Fay, touch shot, block back by Byers. Fay didn't get it quite high enough.
Big block by Josiah Byers. He was hanging up there, very disciplined, did not reach over, press, get that cable. Very, very disciplined shot.
That's an out serve. CSUN helping Hawaii out down the stretch here. And it is one of the seniors, Kupono Fay, fittingly behind the line with Hawaii 2 points away from a senior night victory. Overpass, Mol!
Senior serves, forces a bad pass. Another senior buried. How fitting.
And the SSC rises to its feet.
This is the crowd that Hendrik Mol sent this morning's paper. We ride the sails of our fans every night.
Right now, the wind blowing strong. Aloha ball for the match. Green. Off the block, diving save, Stein. And then put down by Byers. So it's not Pau yet. It remains Aloha ball. Hawaii, a point away from ending the regular season on a win. From completing an unbeaten home regular season schedule. To go 16-0 in this building here in 2017. Middle set, Mol! Dug up by Byers. Bump set, Green over the double block. Right there is Kupono Fay. He gets the set in the back row. Was there a touch? Yes, there was. And this match is over. Hawaii victorious on senior night.
Franciskovic. Kupono Faye picking up his 16th kill to Tyler Rosenmeyer. So high in that area, you see Kyle Faye and Shelly Faye there cheering on their son and all of the Warriors.
Time now for the Fujitsu air conditioning cool play of the match. We got Iain McKellar with the stuff early in set one. Jennings with the solo roof. Kupono Faye dunking it down. And Hendrik Mol saying, oh, no, you don't. The four seniors all getting in and faring heavily into the result tonight.
Yeah, they really put on a performance, and what was nice to see as far as Hawaii fans are concerned is the way Hawaii bounced back after the disappointing loss in the third set. You got to give a lot of credit to the CSUN. Yeah, they played well in that set. They deserve to win it. You know, they hit 464 in that set. Hawaii only hit 260, so give a lot of credit to CSUN. They battled hard.
Bank of Hawaii presents the players of the match. For CSUN, Dimitar Kalchev, 12 kills, 2 aces, 2 blocks, 4 digs. And for Hawaii, the seniors getting the nod, and they will be honored officially with the senior ceremony to come during our postgame on the other side.
Plus, there'll be, apparently, according to Shelly Faye, some entertainment to boot.
Yeah, it's going to be a special one. So stay right there. Get comfy. That does it for our coverage of the match, but the post-game show and the senior festivities to come. Chris McLaughlin, it's been a fun ride here through the regular season. We may not be done. Hawaii hoping to host an MPSF playoff game in this building. But for the time being, 2017 regular season home schedule is POW, and Hawaii makes the run through it unblemished.
It's been a real pleasure. Thank you, Kanoa. I hope we have one more here.
For Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. Stay tuned, folks. See you next time. Aloha.
And welcome back to Stan Sheriff Center. Hawaii completes a perfect season at home, going an unbeaten 16-0, winning in 4. But it's time now to celebrate the seniors. We go to the public address announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here to present our Hawaii seniors with their plaques. Please welcome, representing the University of Hawaii Federal Credit Union, our Vice President of Member Support, Travis Bow, and Vice President of Compliance, David Hamada, along with University of Hawaii Athletics Director, David Matlin, and Sport Administrator, Lois Manning. Volleyball fans, at this time, would like to recognize our senior class, who played a big part in the success of the Rainbow Warrior Volleyball program these past 4 years, including 2 20-win seasons and 3 playoff appearances. Our first senior made the trek to Mauna from Manchester, England, where he was a member of England's junior national team for 4 years. During his time with the Rainbow Warriors, he saw action at opposite, then middle blocker, before moving back to opposite. This senior has appeared in 42 career matches, making 18 starts. He will graduate in May with a degree in economics and will continue to play volleyball while pursuing a graduate degree in England. His favorite memory was last year's road win at Pepperdine. He says he will always remember playing here in the Stan Sheriff Center. Volleyball fans, please show your aloha with a 6'7" opposite from Macclesfield, England, co-captain number 9, Iain McKellar.
And Iain McKellar, a special moment for him earlier this tonight where he got the opportunity to be in the starting lineup, but he has definitely been a large contributor to this Warrior team over the years. Head coach Charlie would say that he was one of the key factors for Hawaii's success 2 years ago when Hawaii ascended to the number one position, because he pushed the team so hard in the practice gym. He went down with an ACL injury and that kind of set him back, but he came back stronger, played middle, and really has been a team player for this team.
Such a huge contributor. You know, he's played 5 years. He's put in so much time. He's really been one of those unselfish players who's been a role model for the younger players, especially the international players, just taking them under his wing and showing them the ropes. a gifted left-handed opposite player.
And his family making the way all the way from England. Father John and his mother Carol, as well as his younger brother, also making the trip over the pond and over the Pacific, all the way here to Hawaii. And a nice special moment between Charlie Wade and Iain McKellar.
His brother Chris, former teammate Siki Zarkovic, and many other friends and family. Like our first senior, our next honoree traveled over two oceans and a continent to be a part of the Rainbow Warriors. An accomplished beach volleyball player, this senior overcame a serious eye injury and has started every match over the past two seasons. This year, he ranks among the nation's leaders in hitting percentage and blocking. He will graduate in May with a degree in physics and hopes to qualify for the 2020 Olympics in beach volleyball for his native country, Norway. He lists his favorite moment as last year's victory over top-ranked UCLA here in the Stan Sheriff Center. He says he will always remember the endless support the team receives each night from the incredible fans. Volleyball fans, put your hands together for the 6'6" middle blocker from Sen, Norway, number 8, Hendrik Mol.
And what a story about Hendrik Mol. Just the journey that this young man has gone through, not only on the volleyball court, but off. Remember, he came in as an outside hitter. He moved to the opposite and then settled in at the middle. And of course, that eye injury that really set him back a few years ago really tested his character. He actually had to change his major after that injury because of the amount of class time that he missed. Lot of transition that this young man has had to go through, but just a physical player who has continued to just grow and develop over the years.
And him looking forward to playing, continuing on, as well as playing beach volleyball for his country. He's a beach player out of Norway. His mom was an Olympian. He has transitioned, and I think he's just coming into his own. He just continues to amaze me in the middle.
His mom, Marita, is here in attendance. She was also with him while he was in UCLA getting those treatments.
Ladies and gentlemen,
to see his mom making the trip over to Hawaii as he greets her right now on the stand here for.
And you know, during the match,
our next senior came to Hawaii as one of the nation's top setting prospects out of Oak Christian High School in California, and will finish his career as a 3-year starter and most certainly an All-America nominee. He's having his best season yet in 2017 and has quarterbacked the Rainbow Warriors to among the best offenses in the country. This senior will finish his career 7th all-time in career assists. He will graduate in May from the Schuyler College of Business with a double major in entrepreneurship and marketing and aspires to earn his MBA after professional volleyball career. He lists his favorite moment as the 5-set win over Pepperdine during his sophomore year. He says he will always remember the fans and playing in the Stan Sheriff Center. Volleyball fans, let's hear it for the 6'5" setter from Westlake Village, California. Floor captain number 10, Jennings Franciskovic.
And the evolution of Jennings Franciskovic has just been simply amazing to watch. Remember last season, unfortunately, losing that starting role, it was something that really bothered him. It motivated him to come back stronger. And this is senior season. Many say that he is the MVP of this team in just his sheer physicality and what he's been able to do. A human highlight reel at times. He is another player that I think has a future in professional volleyball. No doubt about it.
Well, never a question about his athleticism by any means, but this year he turned it around mentally and became a true team leader. And his growth and his maturity has really showed. I think that he is probably, in my book, probably the most improved player on this team.
Let's go, Jenny! Ladies and gentlemen, before we introduce our final senior, please welcome Keala Kahuanui Paleka.
aki e ki e o ku wa ko e ku ma ko e ku ma ko ko ma mo mo e pore ka u wi e tu wa to e tu vi vole ku pa ma we ku e ku ka na ka ku ke i ma wa mau e no e
Yo,
I'm cool.
Yo,
I don't know what you're
doing. Who
I'm cool? Who? Tomato, tomato.
Senior has proudly represented his home state night in and night out the past four seasons as a Rainbow Warrior. A third generation University of Hawaii athlete, he has played in 104 career matches at outside hitter. This senior has been a steady all-around contributor each season, and this year ranks among the team leaders in kills, aces, and digs. He will graduate in May with a degree in civil engineering and aspires to play professionally overseas. He lists his favorite match, a win over UC Santa Barbara during his sophomore year. He says he will always remember the friendships he's made with his teammates over the past 4 years. Volleyball fans, show your aloha for the 6'5" outside hitter from Honolulu, Oahu, number 21, team captain, Kupono.
Generation, as we see Charlie Wade and Kupono Fei embrace. Charlie Wade said that he really wanted Kupono Fei coming out of high school, one of the players that he felt could really set the tone and trying to keep some of these local players here out of Punahou, plays with so much heart, a third generation athlete, and just a great role
joining
model
Kupono
for all
on the
Kiki of Hawaii.
And what's so hard to believe that he's already a senior. I feel like he's just coming into his own again. Such a great contributor and a role model for this team and for the islands.
See his mom, Shelly, there. Father Kyle also in attendance, as well as a lot of family and friends who are in the tunnel waiting to greet Kupono. And again, we talked about at the top of the broadcast in our Game On segment, but he comes from a long lineage of family. Of course, his cousin, Micah Christensen, we know all about the number of accolades that he's been able to achieve in his career. And Kupono, really just another one of those players in a very talented family.
His father, Kyle, his grandparents. There's a long line back there with family and friends.
I mean, just look at the amount of legs that Kupono already has on his neck. And he hasn't even made it halfway through that tunnel yet.
Keep in mind, this may be senior night, but there's a distinct possibility these guys will be back on the floor on April 15th.
Yeah, make me cry, I think a lot of fans here are hoping that this is not the last time that they see this team play here. And we talked about during the broadcast who would be the first one to shed a few tears. I'm not sure if any of the players did, but it looks like Charlie Wade may have shed a few tears. And you know, Charlie is actually an emotional guy. He can get fired up. He will shed a few tears even after a win.
Alrighty, we'll take a break, come back, and we'll have more of the celebration of the seniors here in the Stan Sheriff Center.
Welcome back to the post-game show on OC Sports.
And welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. Of course, it's senior night. There you see the four guys right there. Let's take a look at the senior video. Stay tuned. We'll have more and wrap things up after the video.
Just staying home, playing in front of my family and friends, playing the stand, which is just a dream come true. I've always wanted to play in the stand since I was a little kid. It's just been a tremendous journey.
The biggest part that I remember was one of the first nights I was here, I got to go to a homecoming weekend Wahine game, and it was like sold out, and I was like, this is like the most people I've ever seen at a volleyball game. Like, I was like texting like my mom and dad who are on the official with me. It's like, I want to commit like right now. Like, this is like amazing. Like, there's no place like Hawaii playing volleyball wise, where like the support that we have from everyone on the island, and just in general, the love for the game, you don't have that anywhere else in the world. You know, I've talked to so many of the different foreign guys on our team about this, and it's really something that we need to cherish. And, you know, right away on my official visit, I felt that, and I knew this was the place I wanted to play my volleyball.
I told myself, if I lose 20% of eye-hand coordination or just general coordination, then I'm gonna get 50% stronger. 10% faster, 20% smarter. Just way up for the negatives that injury had to me. Quitting was never an option for me.
Really, I think the one defining thing was seeing Stan Sheriff and the crowds that it brings, and how much love the island has for the sport of volleyball. And that's not really something you see elsewhere in America. That's something I never experienced back home in England. And it's been incredible.
Coming in freshman year, I wasn't strong, but I just wanted to get better. I got reps with Colby, and he pushed me, and Joby helped me out back then. And, you know, I just always wanted to get better. And I think I've just grown as an athlete, as a man, as a person. So, and it's just a great opportunity. And I'm just so thankful for coming here and having Charlie and all my teammates. It's awesome.
I've been through a lot whilst I've been here, big ups and downs, and that's really helped me grow as a person. Dealing with adversity and knowing that I have my teammates and my brothers around me was a huge for me. That was a huge deal.
I'm gonna really miss this team. Specifically, this year has been like the closest team I've ever been on. Like, really, we are a band of brothers. We've talked about this, where, you know, everybody is supporting everyone no matter what, and everybody just wants everyone to be successful. And I've never been a part of a team like that. And I think everyone's just kind of bought into the whole process. And I give a lot of credit to the coaching staff, because I feel like they've really set a standard at the beginning of the season. And then the leaders on the team kind of took that upon ourselves then to try and shape what we think this program could be in the future.
Just that feeling when you're back, you're ready for a serve, and you can hear the collectiveness of 5,000 people roaring at you. It's pretty insane, and it is really unique. I think I've never seen anything like this, and it might be a while until I see something like this ever again from a player perspective.
I think I'll definitely miss the fans the most. Their support has been unbelievable. Like I said, back in England, we have nothing like that. That was crazy to even imagine that I would be signing autographs after games and getting to see these people who just love us so much and want to come support us.
They'll just go out to like Sandy's or like Costco or something, and they'll get people talking up to them, and they'll just start realizing just how special this place is.
It's just something about playing for the state of Hawaii where you have everyone behind you no matter what. And it's really just indescribable, that feeling that you get, where it's indescribable. I don't even know how to like I get just chills thinking about it.
This place is amazing. I'm gonna miss it very much. All the people I've met here, all the experiences I've had. I really can't think of anything else that would be better than to be a Rainbow Warrior.
Return to sender.
Sports Hawaii CSUN night number two. We start with the senior Hendrik Mol. Had a terrific night. 9 kills hit for an even 500. There's one of the 4 blocks on the other side. The guy that can sky, his name is Arvis Green. He gets up there and puts it down. 15 big ones for Arvis Green for CSUN. And there you see a block as well. Talking about blocks, the University of Hawaii blocking. They're second in the country. They didn't hurt their average tonight. 12 blocks in the 4-set win. Leading the way with 5 blocks was Jennings Franciskovic, the center, as you see the triple roof right there. But the star of the night, the sophomore, Brett Rosenmeyer. Rosie, as everybody calls him, with 16 kills. Hit 560 from the left side. He also had a couple of blocks. 3 digs as Hawaii wins it in 4 to close out the home portion of the regular season, where Hawaii finishes 16-0 on the floor at the Stan Sheriff Center.
Welcome back to the post-game show on OC Sports.
Night, as you expect, senior night, Hawaii goes out winners, and they inch closer to hosting a first round match on the 15th of April.
Well, this team, I mean, I'll tell you what a night. Just ending it there with the haka, they are so together. They are all in, each and every one of them. They are just, I don't know what else to say besides you got to love it when these friendships are that dear and the senior night implodes in just so much aloha. You could not even recognize those young men underneath the amount of lei over their heads.
And way to make it interesting for Hawaii. I mean, dropping set number 3, really kind of getting maybe a little bit too loose going into that third set. But really a fantastic night from the technical aspect. For the outside hitters, Kupono Fei with 16 kills and Brett Rosenmeyer, the sophomore, with 16 kills, hitting 560. So, you know, I think this season we saw Hawaii led by their opposite attack in Stein von Tilburg. But tonight, those outside hitters really stepped it up when Hawaii needed them the most.
It was a night of the outsides, and you can't wish for a better closure for this emotional night.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. Let's take a look now at the MPSF standings and Levitt, Yamani, and Solder. Look at that now. Hawaii 12-4, so they only have, as we know, 2 more matches remaining. BYU, Long Beach State, they split their matches this weekend in Provo, but Long Beach State won in 3 today, so they hold the tiebreaker over the Cougars. All right, the upcoming schedule, well, next weekend on the road to Southern California for a pair against UCLA, and then of course on to the postseason of the MPSF, where we're all keeping our fingers crossed that Hawaii will be able to host a first round match on the 15th of April, which is a Saturday. They still have a little work to do though. Generally we think, and there you see the schedule right there, the 7th and 8th, but I think we all kind of figure that if Hawaii can split at UCLA, in fact we know if they split at UCLA, they'll be back home for sure.
And that's going to be a tall order. Winning in Westwood is very difficult, especially with the amount of talent that UCLA has. They have some injuries. We know Michael Ma'a hasn't been playing for a little bit because of a back injury. They also had some injuries to their outside hitters as well as to their middle attackers. So, but we'll see how UCLA puts up a fight. I know that they are also in contention for seeding rights as well, so they're going to come up fired up. But really, tonight was an important win for Hawaii to just sort of get that momentum going in with confidence to UCLA.
And you got to keep in mind, we talked in the Game On segment about the RPI. I know you don't want to look ahead, but those things do matter. You've got to continue to win to give yourself a shot. And if you don't win the MPSF tournament, that you'll be one of the 2 at-large spots. If you win the MPSF tournament, it doesn't matter.
Well, this season, either way, I mean, not to jump way ahead, but I think, if anything, this team will host potentially, if they don't, potentially an at-large bid with the season that they've had so far.
Yeah, I think that was close. You know, what we've seen over the years is that Hawaii has not played at the same level after the season as they play during the season. But I think with this team, I think they'll be able to maintain this level and play at a high level down the stretch.
You know, Sieg, you're a good guy to ask because 2 years ago you were on that team.
Yes.
That got the at-large, went to the NCAA tournament. But you guys kind of started to fade down the stretch. Do you see a difference in this year's squad as opposed to the one 2 years ago?
I feel it does because we have a lot of guys that went through that, and I'm sure that they learned from the past experience that you cannot think you're too good to beat anybody. So I think that's the one mistake that we did, but I think this year is going to be a little different.
Yeah, I think one of the other contributing factors for that season was the injuries, right? Yes. So Hendrik Mol was out, Iain McKellar had an injury, so the team, like Siki and the starters, weren't necessarily pushed as hard in the practice gym. The competitiveness in this gym, in gym one and in gym two during the week is insane. I mean, these players are still going after it, and that's what's keeping, I think, this team at such a high level, and you really are going to need that heading down into the postseason stretch.
Think about this, guys. This team went 16-0 here at home in the Stan Sheriff Center. It's only the second unbeaten season at home for a Warrior volleyball team. The other time was back in the Clum Gym days where they went 8-0, but 16-0, that's incredible.
Well, it's almost contagious. You start winning and that's all you know how to do. And that's a great problem to have when you are at home. That has been in the past one of the concerns we've all had as this team on the road. And this year so far, they've actually done really well on the road, minus Long Beach State and BYU.
Hey, the four of us. Let's plan on being back here on the 15th of April. It's a Saturday, Siki.
I look forward to that.
Siki's only available on Saturdays. He's such high demand, I tell you. All right, that'll do it for us here tonight. Another successful evening for Charlie Wade's Rainbow Warriors. Take your sporting passion to the next level online at OCSports.tv and on Oceanic Time Warner Cable with OC Sports Enhanced. Be a fan and mahalo for making University of Hawaii sports your passion. For entire hardworking, outstanding, and award-winning crew, for Lisa, for Ryan, for Siki, I'm Scott. Until next time, we bid you aloha and a good evening from the Stan Sheriff Center in Manoa.